Hello, I'm XuriTT, and today we will find out how many anime episodes we have to wait before the truthful Pokemon introduced in the given generation debuted on the screen. Of course, we only count appearances in the main part of the episode, we ignore openings. We are also looking for appearances in person, so we mention other things like posters, flashbacks, some other things, but we do not count them as a debut. We use episode numbering from Bulbapedia. It also includes Japanese-only episodes, such as clip shows, but in general, differences with other numberings are minimal. The topic of how Pokemon episode can be numbered is an interesting one, and I will probably come back to it in a separate video. So, let's get started. The first generation is the Kanto region, and the first three Turtle Pokemon, Squirtle, Tiny Turtle Pokemon, his evolution, Water 2, Turtle Pokemon, and the final form, Blastoise, Shellfish Pokemon. In the first episode, Pokemon, I choose you, Squirtle appears three times, but we can't count any of these appearances as a debut. He first appears on a poster in Ash Room, and soon we see him on the TV screen in Professor Oak program that Ash is watching. Finally, Ash dreams that he chose Squirtle as his starter. Squirtle appears in person in episode 12, Here Comes the Squirtle Squad, but it's very solid appearance, we see 5 Squirtles at once. Wartortle first appears in episode 53, the perfect hero, but we can only see him in the Who's That Pokemon segment. The actual debut is episode 60, Beach Blank Out Blastoise, where there is a lot of sense with them. Blastoise has the most complicated debut history. Before appearing in the full sense of the word, he first had 4 episodes of other appearances. First, in episode 17, Island of the Giant Pokemon, he appears as a huge giant robot. It is also worth mentioning that this is one of the more unique episodes of the anime, because we can find out what Pokemon says. Of course, they still only say their names, but we have subtitles and can read their lines. And one more interesting fact, this episode was also published in book form by Scholastic. I have this version in my collection. In the 20th episode, The Ghost of Maiden's Peak, Blastoise appears as an illusion, and he fuses with Venusaur, they combine into one Pokemon. The world fusion idea is quite unique. We don't see many ideas like this in Pokemon anime. It looks more like something from the Dragon Ball. In episode 25, Primeape goes bananas. He is shown in a flashback when Ash tells how he got his hat. After a solid break, we find another highlight in episode 55, Pokemon Paparazzi, where a guy named Todd has a Blastoise mask. Finally, the actual debut takes place in episode 60, Beach Blank Out Blastoise. The entire episode is focused on the turtle shell-shaped island where Blastoise, the leader of the local Squirtles and Wartortles, lives. This episode also marks the debut of Wartortle, as mentioned earlier. Blastoise also has a Mega and Gigantamax forms, but we will discuss this later with 6th and 8th generation. The 2nd generation, introducing the Johto region, is so far the only generation without any new turtle, with a bit of stretching in the case of the 6th generation, which introduced the Kalos region, that also did not add a turtle per se, but introduced Mega Blastoise. The 3rd generation introduced the Hoenn region and one turtle, Torkoal, called Pokemon. In the episode 48, Zigzag Zangoose, Torkoal is in the Pokemon Trainer Church segment as one of the 3 possible answers, the wrong one. In the episode 52, Chair Pressure, Torkoal is again featured in the Pokemon Trainer Choice, but this time he is the correct answer. Finally, he makes his debut in episode 55, Poetry Commotion, where Torkoal trained by Flannery appears. The 4th generation is the Sinnoh region, and one of the starters is again a turtle. So we have 3 new turtles, the grass ones, Turtwig, a tiny leaf Pokemon, his evolution, Grotul, a groove Pokemon, and the final form, Torterra, a continent Pokemon. Turtig doesn't fuck
Squirtle,
around.
Squirtle.
He makes his debut in the first episode of the series, following a maiden's voyage. Firstly, he is visible on Dawn's invitation, then in her imagination. When she reached the professor, you can see all three basic forms of Sino starters. Without any previous non-counting appearances, we only see Grotul when Ash Turtwig evolves in the episode 100, hiding the enemy. Torterra, trained by Paul, also plays a large part in this episode, helping Grotul get used to the new form. But speaking of Torterra, he debuts much earlier in episode 40, Top-Down Training. The mentioned Torterra trained by Paul appears. There is also a mention that he was his first Pokémon, so he got him from Turtwig. Similar to Grotul, Torterra debuts without any prior non-counting appearances. The 5th generation brings the Unova region and two new turtles. The most ordinary of all, Tirtoga, proto-turtle Pokémon, and the evolution, Karakosta, also a proto-turtle Pokémon. Tirtoga made her debut in the episode 75, A Restoration Confrontation, Part 1. First, we see her as a fossil. Then, in the picture, she appears also in the memories flashback of one of characters. At the end of the episode, she is restored from a fossil so you can see her in person. Karakosta appears in a flashback in the episode described above, and we can see her in person in the next one, 76, A Restoration Confrontation Part 2. Tirtoga, discussed above, evolves into this form. This two episode was the last appearance of Tirtoga and Karakosta for a long time. The next one took place in the 58th episode of the Journey series, but more about this episode at the end. The 6th generation introduced the Kalos region and didn't add any new turtles, but it did introduce a mechanic known as Mega Evolution, and one of the Pokémon that got this option was Blastoise, so the repertoire of the new turtles has grown anyway. It's worst case with the debut, because Alor the Mega Form Blastoise appeared in Arceus Glory in the Pokémon Mega Evolution Special 1 episode. It is a special episode and we are focusing on the main series. And in this mega form he only appears in the form of flashback in the episode 133, Coming Apart at the Dreams. The flashback comes from the mentioned Mega Evolution Special. In a personal form, in a normal, regular episode, as far as we know, Mega Blastoise didn't have the opportunity to appear. The 7th generation added the Alola region and one turtle Pokémon, Turtonator, the Blast Turtle Pokémon. It didn't take long for him to debut. Turtonator, trained by Kyawe, appeared in the very first episode, Alola to New Adventure. Kyawe was one of the main characters, so he and Turtonator also appeared in many, many episodes throughout the series. Generation 8 features the Galar region and two new turtles, Chuchu, Snapping Pokémon, and his evolution, Dreadnought, Bite Pokémon. Additionally, this generation introduced the Gigantamax mechanic, which makes Pokémon, well, gigantic. Two Pokémon turtles got this opportunity, the aforementioned Dreadnought, and of course, Wes, the 5th generation Blastoise. Uniquely, we will start with the evolutionary form. Dreadnought appears in his normal form at the end of episode 12, Flash of the Titans, and a little later he takes the Gigantamax form. So we have a W debut. The storyline of the huge Dreadnought and the fight against him continues in the next episode, 13, The Climb to be Very Best, where the base form Chuchu makes his debut. Gigantamax Blastoise didn't appear in the anime at all. In the latest, 9th generation, introducing the Palkia region, one turtle Pokémon appeared, Terrapagos. He has no evolution, but has two forms, normal and terrestrial. So far, only the regular form has appeared in anime. Already in the first episode, he appears in the form of a pendant, but we do not know yet that it is a Pokémon. In the second episode, we can see how it wakes up from the form of the pendant and we can see him in his full glory. So, time for a little summary. Apart from the Mecha and Gigantamax forms of Blastoise, which didn't appear at all in the anime in normal episodes, Grotul had to wait the longest for his debut, until the episode 100. For the next two, we also have a lot of waiting. 76 episodes for Karakosta and 75 episodes for Tirtoga. But they are fossils anyway, so why rushing? The next result surprised me. Alor the War Turtle as a mid-starter form is typically overlooked. The fact that Blastoise also had to wait until the 60th episode, it's not something I expected. We waited a little shorter, 55 episodes for Torkoal's debut. We had to wait 40 episodes for Torterra and this is the last Pokemon with a large number of episodes. The remaining 6 ones we get definitely faster. 13 was a lucky number for Trutul, because in this episode he made his debut. Just one episode less we waited for Squirtle and Drednaw, also as a Gigantamax form, to debut. Terrapakos gets almost the lowest possible score. He debuted in the second episode. However, there were the Turtle Pokémon that debuted in the first episode of the series, Turtonator and Turtwig. As a honorary mention, we must say a few words about a role-leaking role, Eyes on the Goal, the 58th episode of the Journey series, which is also the 1143rd episode of the Pokémon anime overall. All regular forms of Turtle Pokémon appears in it. Regulars, so without Mega and Gigantamax form, and of course, without Terrapagos, which was added a generation later. This is the only case in the entire anime when you can see all the turtles in, excluding episodes like Speech, Blank of Blastoise from the 5th season, where in theory there are also all the turtles, but then it was only a Squirtle and his evolution. And here comes a complete set of 11 Pokémon, and their trainer, Shell Sage, who moves while standing on the back of the Blastoise pyramid. The only downside is, unfortunately, that this is an episode with two stories. The first half is without a turtles, in the second half Trutul appears, then Turtwig, and then more turtles. This episode also confirmed that the division of Pokémon I adopted is correct. Some people also count Shuckle from the second generation or Avaluk from the sixth to be turtle Pokémon, but I never talked of them as turtles. Thanks for watching, leave a like and subscribe if you like it and I hope to see you again in another video. Bye!